Frozen Movie Storybook Part 1. On the edge of a fjord, a deep mountain lake, ringed by majestic peaks, the kingdom of Arendelle was a happy place. During the day, shopkeepers, fishermen, and ice sellers kept the city bustling. At night, the northern lights often lit up the sky in beautiful patterns. The rulers of Arendelle, the king and queen, were kind. Their young daughters, Elsa and Anna, were the joy of their lives. The older daughter, Princess Elsa, had a magical secret. She had the power to create snow and ice. Anna adored her big sister and wanted to spend every minute with her. One night, Anna convinced Elsa to turn the Great Hall into a winter wonderland. They made a snowman together, and then Elsa created ice slides so Anna could soar through the air. But Elsa accidentally hit Anna with a blast of icy magic. Anna fell to the ground, shivering. A streak of white appeared in her hair. The worried king and queen rushed their daughters to the trolls. They were mysterious healers who knew all about magic. A wise old troll was able to cure Anna by helping her to forget the injury and the magic. He also had a warning. Elsa's power will grow, he said. She must learn to control it. Elsa was afraid that she would hurt her sister again. She spent her time practicing to keep her magic under control. It was difficult, especially when she became upset. As a precaution, the king decided to keep the castle gates closed. Anna couldn't remember Elsa's magic, but she still wanted to play with Elsa. No matter how much Anna pleaded, Elsa refused to open her door. Years passed, but the girls didn't grow any closer, even when their parents were lost at sea. Then one summer day, it was time to crown Elsa as queen. Guests from far away sailed to Arendelle for the coronation. Anna was excited to meet so many new people, especially a handsome young prince named Hans. Meanwhile, Elsa was still struggling to hide her powers. She just hoped she would make it through the day. Suddenly, bells rang. The ceremony was about to begin. To Elsa's relief, the coronation went exactly as planned. Afterward, a party was held in the Great Hall. Anna and Prince Hans spent the evening laughing and talking. It was love at first sight. Anna introduced Hans to Elsa and announced that they were engaged. Elsa objected, "You can't marry a man you just met." "You can if it's true love," Anna replied. "My answer is no," Elsa said firmly and started to leave the room. Anna couldn't believe that Elsa was walking away without talking to her. Feeling upset, she grabbed Elsa's hand and accidentally pulled off her glove. "Why do you shut me out?" Anna asked. "Enough!" Elsa cried. Suddenly, an icy blast shot from her uncovered hand and coated the room in ice. Everyone stared in shock. Frightened by her own power, Elsa fled from the hall. As she ran through Arendelle, everything froze around her. "Stay away from me," Elsa warned her subjects. She didn't want to hurt anyone. The townspeople were confused and afraid. "Monster!" yelled the Duke. Even the fjord froze as Elsa stepped onto the water. All the ships were locked into the ice. Elsa quickly crossed the fjord and ran up into the mountains. As Elsa climbed higher, she let her powers loose. For the first time, she didn't have to hide them. She used her magic to create a beautiful ice palace at the top of the mountain. It would be Elsa's new home, where she could be free and alone. She'd never hurt anyone again. Elsa's midsummer blizzard covered Arendelle with snow and ice. The whole kingdom was panicking, and Anna knew she had to find her sister. Leaving Hans in charge of the kingdom, she rode into the mountains. But her horse got scared and threw her off. Anna was lucky to find a little trading post. Inside the trading post, Anna bought dry clothes. Just then, the door flew open. In came a mountain man covered in snow. His name was Kristoff, and he said that the storm was coming from the North Mountain. That gave Anna an idea. She found Kristoff in the stable with his reindeer Sven. She asked him to take her up to the North Mountain to find Elsa. Kristoff agreed. "We leave at dawn." "No," said Anna, "we leave right now." As they headed up the mountain, Anna explained how her sister had started the storm, and she told Kristoff about her true love, Hans. Suddenly, a pack of wolves began to chase them. Working together, Anna, Kristoff, and Sven escaped by crossing a deep gorge. But Kristoff's sled crashed into the rocks below.